Welcome to the speed build video in The Sims 4. My name is Irene and today I have something special for you. Today I'm building my post-apocalyptic space shuttle house because yes, it's a house too. The space shuttle will be functional, not as a space shuttle of course, but as a house, but I will build a post-apocalyptic themed house underneath it as well. In this video you can see how I will create a mountain with a crumbled down space shuttle inside it and, like I said, a post-apocalyptic themed house. This build will be completely off the grid. I thought it would be cool to make it as realistic as possible, as far as that was possible for this fantasy build, of course. It's set in a far, far future when the world is crumbled down, but us mankind made the best of it with the remnants of the earth from a distant, distant past. I did not even write it down. But I had that in my mind while building this and I cannot wait to share it with you guys. I wanted to do a post-apocalyptic build again. I did one before my break. I think I just called it a post-apocalyptic house. It was with crumbled down buildings. Could be set in the middle of a city. And yes, I had so much fun with that. It was not even like building a house in the game, but more creating my own design of a game inside a game, if that makes any sense. And yes, it was so cool to do and I wanted to do a post-apocalyptic build again. While I was away on my short break, I've been playing Fallout 4 again for hours and hours and hours. And yes, I did a lot of gameplay in the game too, but you have a build option in Fallout 4 too. And of course, I built entire cities there. You have different lots where you can build on, different settlements. Some of them are quite small. There's one huge. If you did play Fallout 4 and if you did play it, if you build a lot in Fallout 4 too, maybe you still remember Starlight Drive-In. Huge drive-in cinema, outdoor cinema, and yes, I made a huge city over there and that was so cool. I love building in that style and of course Fallout 4 has a totally different aesthetics, totally different look, but still that crumbled down dirty style of building, I love that. So I wanted to do a post-apocalyptic build again, long story short. So I started gathering inspiration on Pinterest. A lot of you always ask where I get my inspiration. Really, Pinterest. I use Pinterest so much. Most of the time I have an idea in my mind. For example, this time it came from Fallout 4, but sometimes it comes from a movie or what I see on television. And then I search for that idea on Pinterest. And yes, it's my main source of inspiration. And I found a link there to a site from Vice Magazine. And I found an article on Vice Magazine about a guy called, and I wrote that down, Yuri Shvedov. I think I pronounced that wrong. I'm sorry, Yuri. But he's a 23-year-old Russian artist. And he made this picture, concept art. And yeah, when you see it, yeah, I had that picture next to me while I was building this house. The entire look of that image that I found, that concept art of the guy, I loved it. With that space shuttle all crumbled down in a mountain and with that house still underneath it, I just had to use it for a build. But he made so much more cool images, concept art like this one. Unbelievably cool. But I had that first one next to me while I was building this. And yes, it was a huge help, of course. I really took a good look at that picture, especially for the mountain and with that space shuttle in it, of course. You can see while I was talking and explaining about my inspiration, I already did a huge part of the space shuttle here. And of course, I combined roofs together with separate rooms, and after that I just added a lot of finishing touches, small decorations and light strips and other items. the bottom two, yeah, for me this will be a difficult challenge to explain everything in English, because of course there are a lot of strange objects on the space shuttle, and of course I don't know the word for it, so I think you can hear me call things a lot in this video. But the things at the bottom of the space shuttle, not the engines, or where the smoke comes out, where the fire comes out. It's a very, yes, small bin. I think it came with Stranger Fill or Get to Work. No, I think Stranger Fill, and I sized it up a lot, of course. And that's how I made these things at the bottom. The entire space shuttle had to lean on something. I had that picture I just told you about, that concept art picture next to me, but I also had some pictures next to me from space shuttles from NASA. And they're always leaning on a very big tube, orange colored tube, and I used a tube for it, a copper colored tube, because I thought it looked more crumbled down than just a bright orange colored one, and that one came with the Eco Lifestyle pack. It's a debug item. And the things, yeah, a lot of things, the things next to the smaller tubes, next to the copper tube, they are debug items to these antennas, if you will, and they came with the Stranger Fill pack debug item too. So I scrolled a lot through all the debug items when I wanted to give this build finishing touches. I just made the entire mountain underneath this space shuttle, and yes, I talked about methods how to build houses into rocks or into cliffs in my two previous videos, and today it was easier to build the entire space shuttle first, and after that build the mountain underneath it. And I used that same rock again, the debug rock, the one that came with Island Living. I used it while I was doing my dream cliff house as well. And yeah, I talked about it over there too, and the main reason that I love that rock so much, it clips into the ground, so when you raise ground up, you can make builds look very natural if you use that rock. You don't have a rock sticking in the air when you raise the ground up. Normally a rock does that in the game. And as you can see over here, I could place this one off the lot too. And of course I wanted to make this lot look as post-apocalyptic as I possibly could, so I had to erase all pops of color, all trees that I saw outside the lot. And this rock, I think it's the only one that you can really place off the lot over here. As you can see, there are boundaries to it though. You can't place it all the way into the ocean that you can see around the lot. There are boundaries to it, but you can place it off the lot, as you can see. And of course, yeah, like I said, I wanted to have that post-apocalyptic look, no trees at all anymore. So yeah, that's why I use this rock again. I'm building this build on a 64 by 64 lot, and I was so satisfied to build on a 64 by 64 lot again. My previous build was on a 50 by 40, and the one before that 50 by 50, both huge lots as well, but 64 by 64, still my favorite lot, because as you can see right here, I can build a house, but I can build an entire world all around it as well when I have enough space, like over here. But it's a 64 by 64. It is the a lot in Brindleton Bay, the world that came with cats and dogs. And the main reason why I'm building here, the lot size, obviously. But I love the look as well with the open ocean at the back. I thought it would be the coolest for the thumbnail. I thought with just that open look, these open views at the back of the lot, the space shuttle and the entire build would pop a little bit more off your screen while I was taking screenshots, or for the thumbnail, for example. And I thought the entire look was the best over here. But another very important reason why I picked this lot: when you raise up ground on certain lots, you always have that dirt color left. When you raise the ground up a lot on lots, you can paint ground, but certain types of grounds, especially when you raise them up a lot, you can you can't paint it in a different color and in several different lots, especially in other worlds. Sometimes it has a very strange brown color, it's not that pretty, and sometimes it's just totally different color than you want. And in Brindleton Bay, where I'm building it right now, the color is just dark brown and it blends the best with the rocks that I use. So that's why, yeah, I use this lot. And I just love the evening light over here. I have the light from the exact good angle, just from the front, and it just looks the best over here. So that's why I picked it. We're already on to, yeah, the post-apocalyptic house underneath the entire space shuttle, and I actually thought so much about what to do here. I wanted to make it look like, yeah, like a bunker. I didn't want to make it too shiny, of course, because it's a post-apocalyptic build. I had these houses that I made in Fallout 4 in the back of my mind. They all were with a lot of wood and with a lot of concrete. So of course I wanted to use that over here as well, but it was quite difficult because I had just this shape that I wanted to use. I didn't want to make it more complex. I thought it distracted a bit from the space shuttle. So yeah, I thought a lot about it, but in the end I'm actually very happy with the result. I just used a lot of debug items to give this house, yes, post-apocalyptic touches, the crumbled down touches. For example, when you take a look at the front from the house and in the left corner, you can see these brown and gray rocks over there. These rocks, they're actually, yeah, debug item from Cats and Dogs as well. And yeah, over here too, it stood out to me when you use certain items from a certain pack and you place them on a lot in the world that came with that pack as well, they always look a little bit better. And I thought this, yeah, but this item too, I never really used it before, but especially that crumble down aspect, I thought it was a very, very fitting for, yeah, for this post-apocalyptic build. Same for these fences that I'm just placing in. I'm pointing at my screen right now, if you can see it. But yeah, these fences with these, yeah, I just placed them in. They came with Cats and Dogs too, and I thought these colors together, they combined the best. And yeah, I didn't want to make this into a concrete bunker, just a box with only concrete wallpaper. I wanted to give it more, you know, so that's why I used, yeah, all these different debug items everywhere. The wallpaper or the paneling, this metal paneling that I just used on this build, it's so gorgeous. It's so amazing. It came with Strangerville. And yeah, or Island Living. No, I think Strangerville. And I never used it before because, of course, it's a wallpaper. You cannot use it for every single build. And I especially love building luxurious builds, expensive builds. And yeah, these metal fences, metal paneling, it just looks strange on builds like that. But for this build, it was the perfect choice, of course. And in that way, I could make that combination with the wood and with the metal. Same with the door that I just placed in. And that was a fun thing for me while building this, while I'm talking about it. I could use so many items in this build that I would never use in other builds. Like the metal door, like I said, but I used a lot of lights too. They came with Strangerville, and when I see one on screen, yeah, timing, there they were. Amazing item, so well made, it's so cool, but I could never use it in my normally more luxurious builds. But for a crumbled down build, amazing. According to interior, this is my favorite room in the entire build. Yeah, I just placed these stains on the ground, they came with Strangerville. This cool bathtub with the plants in it came with Strangerville as well. We will go back to my favorite room in a couple of seconds, but it's the bathroom actually. I totally embrace the dirty post-apocalyptic feel I constantly had Fallout 4 in my mind. And yeah, I placed these tubes in, of course, this shower. Strangerville came with some amazing post-apocalyptic items, and I could really use them over here. But I just wanted to make this bathroom look dirty, run down, and yeah, it totally worked out, I think. Especially with the metal paneling and with the wood that I use. The wood, the dirty wood paneling that I used on the wall came with that spooky pack. Yeah, I never used that spooky pack. I think it's one of the first stuff packs that came out. So yeah, I just said it. This is an example again. I would never use that paneling in other builds, in luxurious builds, like these crates too. These generators, they came with eco lifestyle. But yeah, for a build like this, I could totally embrace that. And I loved it so, so, so much. Of course, this build is, like I said at the beginning of the video, it's off the grid. But when I placed these items in, it was very strange. I already made a lot off the grid. But as you can see here, these lights, I wanted to place them there just as accent lights. But they were still working. And I think it has something to do with the fact that I placed these generators in. They came with eco lifestyle, these orange things that I just placed in. But I did not really dive into the off-the-grid gameplay yet in the game, so I'm not totally sure, but I think these lights are still working because of these generators. But I didn't place any luxury items here. I placed a candle making station because I thought it looked the most like an armor or a weapon station that you can see in games like Fallout, so that's why I placed it there. And of course, the necessities are here, like a bed and a bathroom. I will place a grill in later on, a barbecue over there next to this picnic table. But of course, not that much, no television or something like that, of course, because it was totally not fitting for this post-apocalyptic build. I attached the space shuttle to this house a couple of minutes ago, and I was so happy that worked out. My initial plan was to make the space shuttle just for decorative purposes and not to make it functional, like attached to the house, but it worked out. I was so lucky that worked out. For the space shuttle though, I wanted to, yeah, you have that house underneath it, that's really your house that you made from the remnants, old remnants of the Earth. But yeah, this space shuttle, I made the interior like it was still a space shuttle. Of course, with these crumbled down items, with these dirty items, they all came with the Strangerville pack. And yeah, I still wanted to, you can go here, you can go into that rocket ship, into the space shuttle, but I didn't make all these levels. Yeah, I made them decorative. But the top level, the upper level, I placed a bed over there and some curtains or some rocks. I didn't place curtains in, I'm sorry. Some rocks there. Yeah, you can see it here. So you can sleep over there at the very, very top. And of course, I think in the here it is. Of course, Baby Yoda had to be in this build, in the space shuttle. So yes, we're into the house tour. Can you still call this a house tour? Let's call it an outro already. I really hope you've enjoyed this build, you've enjoyed this video. Let me know what you thought about it. If you have a request for me to build, please let me know. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. You would make me so happy. Yeah, and then my next video will be this Friday. I really hope to talk to you then. Have an amazing day and well, goodbye.